This video is going to be about reducing fractions to lowest terms. Sometimes this is called simplifying fractions. So here's an example. Let's say we've got the fraction 10 over 15, and we're told to reduce this to its lowest terms, or simplify it. What we do is we see if we can find a number that we can divide into both the numerator and the denominator. And you know, whenever you have a number that ends in a 0 or 5, you can divide that number by 5. So we're going to divide the numerator by 5, and we're going to divide the denominator by 5. When we divide the 10 by 5, we get a 2. And dividing 15 by 5, we get a 3. So 2/3 is a reduced version or a simplified version of the fraction 10/15. Here's another one. Let's say we've got the fraction 18 over 12, and we want to reduce it. Well, I realize both 18 and 12 are even numbers, so I could divide them both by 2. And when I do that, I'll get 18 divided by 2 is 9, and 12 divided by 2 is 6. Now, but we have to be careful, because even though I divided both of these, the numerator and denominator, by 2, I didn't reduce this fraction to its lowest terms. If you think about it, I can divide 9 and 6, I can divide both of them by 3. So I've still got a little more work to do. When I divide the 9 by 3, I'll get a 3. Dividing 6 by 3, I get a 2. Okay, so I wanted to do this way just to show you that you can reduce a fraction in steps. In other words, you can take whatever you see as a common factor, a number you can divide into both the numerator and denominator, even if it's not the biggest number you can find. And once you've done that, look at the result and see if you can reduce it any further. Now, I could have, if I'd recognized that 18 and 12 could both be divided by 6, I could have done this all in one step. So I would divide 18 by 6 and get a 3, and divide 12 by 6 and get a 2. And either way, I get 3/2. This way is faster if you can do it in one step, but the other way will still get you there. Okay, a few more. Okay, here I have the fraction 15 over 21, and I just want to show you another way of looking at it. We could think of 15 as the two numbers that were multiplied to get it. In other words, 15 is 3 times 5. And 21 is 3 times 7. And now I can think of myself as just getting rid of this fraction, 3 over 3, because 3 over 3 is 1. So I could cross both of these 3s out. Basically, I'm factoring them out because they're both factored. 3 is a factor of 15 and 21. And I'm going to be left with 5 over 7. So you can, instead of thinking of yourself as dividing both of these by 3, you could think of yourself as breaking them down, breaking the numbers down into the numbers that are multiplied to make those numbers. And then we'll just cross out anything that's the same in the numerator and the denominator. And I'll get 5/7. So here's one more. I've got a negative 4 over 16. And what I want you to see is just that if a fraction is negative, after you reduce it, it's still going to stay negative. So I'm going to think of this as negative 4 times 1. And my denominator, I'm going to think of as 4 times 4, I can cross out this 4 and cross out this 4, but I'm not crossing out the negative. So I've still got a negative fraction. I've got negative 1 over 4. Thinking this in terms of division, if I have negative 4 over 16, I'll divide the numerator by 4 and the denominator by 4, and I'll get the same answer. So negative 4 divided by 4 is negative 1. 16 divided by 4 is 4. Either way, I get -1/4. Okay, so that's really all there is to it. But make sure you're comfortable with these. The best thing to do is just practice them a bit until you feel like you could do them in your sleep. Okay, take care. I'll see you next time.